Hello friends, in this video I'm going to check this Laravel roles package from the Jeremy Kennedy. Okay, and this package supports all the versions from 5.3 and also the Laravel 9, which I have created the project with Laravel 9. And let's get started. So here we need to copy this command. And I am inside the directory of Laravel 9 project and paste that in. After that, also I'm going to publish all assets. So copy this and paste that one as well. And in the user model, we need to say user role has a role and permission. So let's open the project. I'm going to open with a VS Code. Okay, I'm going to zoom it. And we need to go to the user. So open the user model and I'm going to say as a role and permission. So copy from that and paste it here. And we need to import that traits. Okay. Next, we need to go to the database seeder and I'm going to copy this one and paste that. So open the save this one and open the database seeder. And paste that in. We need also to import the model and save, close this one. And after that, we need to run the composer dump autoload. Okay. And PHP artisan DB seed. So artisan migrate bash dash dash seed. And in the project, as also I have created, installed the Laravel Breeze. And if right now it's going to create those roles, so admin, user, and unverified. So the role has name, Slack, description, and level. And the admin has level 5, the user level 1, and unverified level 0. And also we have created some permissions. We are going to see that because we have the GUI here. So let's go and open the table plus to see this. Open the app database. And here we have roles, 3 roles. And the admin has a level 5, okay. We have role user, permissions, and we have 4 permissions. Permission user and permission role. So how we can assign a role to the user. So creating roles is going to be something like this. Admin role and config roles models role. So we call the model from the config roles and models role. And we can attach the role by saying user attach role and the role here. So let the open the app.test here. And I'm going to register a new user. Okay. And now let's attach a role. So I'm going to get the role something like this. And you see here we can assign a user role to new registered user. So when we register a new user, we can assign directly the role, but I'm not doing that. So just copy this and open the web routes. And here when we return to dashboard, I'm going to say role, and instead of the user, I'm going to say authenticated user. Attach role and the role. Hit save. And right now, if I see here, we don't have any user, and also, yeah, we have a user, but we don't have any relationship role and user. But if I go now and refresh this, go back and refresh, we have a new relationship. So the user has the role user. Also, we can check if the user has a role admin, do something, and or if the user is admin. And also for the level, if the user level greater than 4, which is admin. And here we have attach permission, and I'm not going to do a very deep here. And also we have the blade extensions or role, the same thing we had with Laravel permission package from Spati. So we need also to add this in the kernel PHP. But said you can optionally add them inside your HTTP. So it's not necessary. And if I say role admin, so let's get in here and I'm going to say role admin here, save, go to the browser and refresh. You don't have a required admin role. And why is this? Yeah, middleware role admin. Now, if I say role user, which we have, user, save, go to the browser and refresh. Yeah, but the error is it's not very good. So, admin again. And yeah, you don't have required admin role. Anyway, go back and something. Okay, what we can do other. So I want to see all the roles. So for that, we need to add these roles GUI settings. So I'm going to add all to the .env file. open the .env and paste them here. Roles GUI enable to be true. Save. And we have in middleware enabled, so and the middleware is going to be admin. So if I navigate now, we don't see that. So we need to go inside the role setting. Yeah, permissions or roles. Okay. Come here and say roles. And you don't have required admin role, so we need to add the admin role to this user. And we can do that just instead of user, I'm going to say here admin and save. And if I refresh and go here, now we have two roles. Okay. And if I go now to the roles, and we need to make some changes here. So here we have the layout, and it's not expecting the header here. Okay, undefined variable header, because in the resources views layouts, we have this app layout, and we have also the header. But also, if I remove this, it's not going to work. So come here and refresh. Undefined variable slot. So this is not working with the slot, but we need to create one more new file. Mine.blade.php. And I'm going to copy what we have here and paste it. Just now remove this thing here, and instead of slot, we need to add the yield, the old school, and I think content. Yeah. Save, and come here and refresh. And we have undefined variable yes, because we need also to change this here. So we create this mine layout, and we need to change in the layouts mine here, and save, refresh. And yeah, now we get that. But this is not working with Tiling CSS. This is working with Bootstrap, I think. So let's go to the get Bootstrap. Okay. Get started and copy the CSS here. Go to the MindBlade, and instead of the Tailwind CSS we have here, paste that in. Save. Go to the browser and refresh. And yeah. But I think, no, it's not. I think maybe it's Bootstrap 4. And also remove this one now and add this, the Bootstrap 4, save. Go to the browser and refresh. And yeah, now we have this one here. Also, I'm going to add in the MindBlade. So here I'm going to add a class. Container, save and refresh. Yeah. So here now we have roles, which is the first one is admin, user and unverified. And this role has the level 5 here. I'm going to zoom it. So here, this role has the level 5 and one user has this role, and also the role user has level 1 and one user. This unverified role has level 0 and 0 users has this role. And we have permissions here. One user has them. And active roles, the admin, and the permissions of this role, which is can view users, can create and edit and delete users. So we can show this. We can view, we can edit and delete. Okay, the same thing for the others. And also here we have the permissions. We can show, edit, and also delete. We can create a new role. So go here and create a new role. So test, and it's going to be 2 role level. I'm not going to add any permission yet, so save this. And right now we have test user and has the level 2. The same thing for the permissions. Okay, friends, that's it for this video, just to show you how this work. If you find it useful, you can use for your project. Just go and install, and don't forget to create another layout and add the Bootstrap 4. Hope you enjoy, friends, and see you in the next video. All the best. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Thank you very much.